And welcome back everybody, this is episode 6 of my Donkeycraft Let's Play. And between this episode and the previous one, I have finished the house. Look at that, awesome. It is pretty big now, pretty tall. I made an extra floor up here, made myself a nice roof, and I have place these reappearing blocks. So what they basically do is you click on one of them and it opens, you walk through it, and a few seconds later they reappear, just like how it's called. So up here it's nothing special really, just you can look outside, nice view over the water and stuff. So you come in here, nice jungle saplings, and you got the big room where all my storage is going to be. So leave in the comments if you like this, but I really like this fence with red stained clay and the glowstone. Really love it. I've also changed the roof to jungle wood slabs instead of stone slabs because it looks kind of modernish, but more factory CO2 carbon dioxide pollution stuff ceiling. So it didn't look very great, just a little bit, yeah, way too gray for all this wood in this area. So I decided let's do that. So I've also changed this up. I made some wood here instead of going with the normal wood all the way down. I placed a log, and instead of cloth all the way down, I placed a log up here as well, so it looks kind of the same everywhere and not everything would be different. So right click, walk through. It's awesome. You can see that the glass disconnects and then it reconnects again. So yeah, great. So what we also did in the previous episode is we went to the Twilight Forest and we got some stuff. We got the steel leaves and we got the crystallized soul essence. So I have already made the shadow blade. So you make that with a stick. Two crystallized soul essence. And by the way, don't attack enemies with that sword. Don't. If you do, you could be in some serious trouble. Because what that sword does is it will take the soul of that enemy and place that soul in your crystallized soul essence. Which means you can't use that crystallized soul essence anymore for the mobs you do want to make a spawner with. Because So with the soulshards mod, it works like so. So you get yourself some soul essences with spawners like you've seen last episode, and I really need to surround this lake as well because zombies can drag me to it. That's a little bit annoying. So die you. And yeah, so you get that from demolishing spawners. So luckily we found a huge hill dungeon with a lot of spawners and we got enough to make everything we need. So you make a shadow blade out of that, which can suck up your enemy's souls, and with the soul cage you can place your soul shards into there and the spawner will be created. And the soul essences, just the raw ones, if you kill a monster with that or just a mob, doesn't matter what it will do is it will take a certain amount of crystallized soul essence and convert that in the soul shard of that kind of mob. And every mob, every enemy, or just a cow or something, just every single kind of mob, and where is my cow? Oh, there is it. Okay, so every mob takes another amount of crystallized soul essences, it needs to create a soul shard. So let's say zombies. Zombies are kind of worthless. You can only really use them for collecting experience, because rot of flesh is not really something you want. So that would probably take maybe only one crystallized soul essence. But blazes, the monster that I want to make a spawn with, blazes drop twice as much XP as normal mobs, and it drops blaze rods that are pretty hard to get and pretty useful in a lot of stuff, because they're also, you can use them in a lot of recipes, but they're also a very good fuel source. So that's why it probably takes 5, I think. So that's why I have 5 with me. I have the soul cage and the shadow blade, so I can farm myself some blazes. But what I am going to do first is, this sword is pretty bad right now, because we didn't really add anything to it, and it's not made of a very strong material. So because we found steel leaf in one of those chests, I'm going to make a steel leaf sword that has 7 attack damage, that, if I'm right, that's the same as a diamond sword does. So it's pretty good, and it has looting 2 on it. So what that does is, you have looting 2, so you don't have to enchant it, but if you want to enchant it with something like unbreaking, you can, because there's already an enchantment on it. So it has a good part and a bad part. So yeah, but anyway, this sword is a lot better than that sword, so I'm going to take this one, and this one should have a reasonable durability. So let's do this. Let's go to the Nether and get our stuff done. So Blaze, where are you at? There are you at. Fire resistance is... oh, what happened up here? Oh, wait. These saplings grew. That is just genius. As long as the portal stays, I'm happy. Because that portal took me a diamond, and I don't want it to disappear. So I think I got everything on me. But, oh yes, that's what I thought. I forgot my cobblestone. I really need that right now. Oh, get out. I do have some torches, so that's great. I need them to disable the spawner for a second. Oh, and by the way, the soul shards stuff. Oh wait, my chests are not in there. So with the soul shard stuff, if you kill like one blaze, you will get a tier 1 soul shard. But if you kill a lot of blazes, you will get tier 2, and then tier 3, and tier 4, tier 5. Tier 5 is the best one, and what tier 5 does, what I really want to get, is it spawns very rapidly. It spawns way faster than a normal spawner. What it also does is, it doesn't check if there are more than one blazes around, or if there are any blazes at all. So it will just keep on spawning regardless of the amount of blazes that are already in that room. And what it will also do is, it won't or it will react to redstone signal. So you can disable the spawner with a redstone signal, which is really, really useful if you ask me. So let's see here, where do I have to go? All the way to the end of there. So let's walk. Is it here? Yes, it's here. A little bit further to the right. Yeah, what I need to do is, I need to make a link book to here. That would be very, very useful. So let's kill a couple of blazes, shall we? Get our pickaxe on. Get in there. Make sure we're ready. Yes. Soul shard blaze. So let's kill some more blazes. Don't know how much uses this has. That doesn't matter, I guess. So you used to be able to kill this normal spawner by right clicking it, and that would give you loads and loads of souls in here. So moment doesn't show anything, but I can't do anything with it. I can't get that, but I got a soul shard for blazes, but I don't really know how this works right now. I knew how it worked, but not how it works anymore. So soul shard, come on, soul. Yeah, here. So, oh, you spawned. So I don't seem to get more stuff. That's a binding shard. I don't know what to do with that well. So do I just have to place this down? It aren't there any tears anymore or what? Now I don't know it anymore, guys, so let me check on the forum and I will be right back. And welcome back, guys. And I don't seem to be able to upgrade my soul shard anymore. It's just soul shard blaze is a soul shard blaze and can't do anything with it. So yeah, that's unfortunate. So let's delete the spawner, I guess. Place my spawner in here somewhere. That I want it to be there. Make the ceiling a little bit higher. That. I also need to delete these things because fences, as you can see, I can stand on here. And with normal spawners, that decreases the amount of blazes spawn rate, because there are already blazes very, very nearby. I don't know if that is the case with the soul shard spawner, but I will just remove them in case it does, because it shouldn't if you would have made your soul shard to tier 4 or to tier 5. But now soul shards aren't in tiers anymore, so there is a possibility that because there aren't any tiers anymore, it is just a normal spawner that you can only turn off with redstone. So I've only read that you can do that still, but I couldn't find anything more. So yeah, anyway, I think this should be high enough. Maybe let's go down one more. What we need to do then is pretty simple. So I've made this long but small. Well, it seems. So let's check that out. Two from there, two from there, two from there, two from there. So it should be good. Oh wait, I can fly, of course. This should be the middle. Okay. Now, this is only 3, and from here it's 2. So yeah, let's cover this up then. Good thing I brought that much cobblestone with me. So let's just do this. And by the way, if you're playing on this mod pack, you might notice that you don't have soul shards. And if you really want soul shards, that could be a problem, because you don't have it. So yeah, what you can do is you can go to the download page of soul shards and download it there if you really want it. So just type in Google soul shards 1.6.4 and you should find it. So yeah, this should be high enough. So what happens, bases spawn, they come all the way down, they chill on here, and then a minute later they will walk off themselves and walk themselves. I could do all business up here, but I don't feel like it, because I would need a lot of stuff that I don't have. So yeah, let's not do that. I also want a bunch of slabs, because other mobs could spawn here. I don't want that to happen. So because I do slabs right there, it might be too high to the spawner, too close to it. So let's go one more down, place them here, just like so. And you need to make sure that this distance is more than two blocks, so that blazes can't actually jump back up. That could be a problem, of course. And then I want this, that they come here, go one further down, and then this should be good. Let's make staircase up. Hello. Ah, there. What is this? Tin ore. I don't need that. So that means I can go down. And I do want some glass up here. And I probably want... Did I exactly use it? Yes, I exactly used all of my slabs. So let's place one there, so they think there's a spawnable area in the neighborhood. Let's go down. I want to get myself some glass for here. And what I also want is a turtle. Yes, we are going to be playing with turtles. Oh yes. That's very nice, right? So let's go down. This is the place where blazes should fall in. And what I want is that they are here. There is a turtle right there, right here. And then there should be pipes coming down underneath the blazes into the chests here and here. And then I can stand somewhere. Oh, wait. Wait a second, what am I doing? What? I don't get it. Did you guys hear those guests? What the what? Okay. Okay, so here that turtle, just want that. And then what I could do is go a little bit further down so I can stand up here with half steps there. That should prevent blazes from getting to me, but it also prevents me from getting somewhere else. Yes, let's make this one lower then. Nope. That was a mistake, and that was a mistake as well. Get these up. And of course I throw them on the ground. Why wouldn't I throw them on the ground? It's always fun to just throw your torches on the ground. So Blaze is up here, which means that up there. So Blaze is gonna get out. I can see them. Well, maybe they are able to see me as well. So let's do that. That. And then chest should be right here. With this covering everything so I won't get burned. So I can just stand here and get all the XP, because turtles, if a turtle kills a an enemy, they will still drop XP. So let's get home, and I will see you there, and then we can make some turtles. And welcome back, guys. So let's get to those turtles. You can simply search it up in your NEI. Turtle caps lock. Yes, it should still do that. It's not capital sensitive. You need a melee turtle. So why am I not getting the recipe of melee turtle? Yeah. So you need a turtle and a diamond sword. Turtle is 8 iron around a computer and a chest. Computer is 7 stone, redstone and glass pane. I should have that. So let's make some glass panes. Like so. And where's my stone? I should have some stone up here somewhere. Over here, yes. 7 stone. And that. Also need 7 iron, and the chest I can make. Like so. So neat trick, if you do your, if you are on your crafting table, you can press, well, you can always press R on a item in any eye to get your recipe. But if you are on the crafting table and you do that, and you go to the computer, or any recipe for that matter, you can shift click on this question mark, and it automatically shows all the items here, and you can just take it out. Only if you of course have all the items on you, otherwise you would be cheating. So you can do that like that as well. Oh. Get myself 2 diamonds. Good thing I found them in the Twilight Forest. Diamond sword, so see? 7 attack, 7 attack, so great. Melee turtle. What I also want is the first pipes we made, we are going to make. The item ducts I want, I believe. So item ducts, so you need the opaque version, not the normal item ducts, because you need hardened glass and you need machines for that, and we don't have that yet. So tin, lead and tin. So let's get 4 tin and 2 lead, and I didn't smelt up lead yet. Let's get myself 2 lead ore and smelt it up. And yes, I am wasting some coal, but I don't really care, because it's coal, and look at the amount of coal I still have. Yes, that definitely is enough for me. So let's get this stuff, and then I should also get myself a lever. I will explain that to you later. So, well, you get 6 right now. I thought you would only get 4, but they might have changed that, or I might have never paid attention. Not enough attention. So we got all the opponents we need, I think. Yes, so I will meet you at the blaze bomb. And there we are. Muscle cage. We are not going to place a spawner in yet. Oh, I forgot the chest. Oh wait, I have wood on me. Phew. And crafting table is still here. So let's do that. Let's do that. 3 and 4. 4 chests. Now that should be enough. So let's first place this one down. Let's get you. And I should place this thing right here. So let's make the code first. So what you do is you right click on your turtle and you will get this screen. So you think, what do I need to do? So what you need to do to create a program, because it is from Computercraft, so it is just a computer program you need to write, and there are some good tutorials out there. So go to the Computercraft wiki, there are loads of tutorials on that wiki, because I am not an expert. I can do some stuff, so I can do edit, which means, yeah, basically you're going to edit the program. So edit, and we're going to name it something like Blaze Kill. Enter. So now you are editing that program, but because that program isn't already made yet, you are going to make that program. So what I'm going to do is while true do, and what this basically says is it checks for something that is true. And is there a netherrack next to me? Yes, that's true. So I'm going to do that. There's always something true. Because if the netherrack wasn't there, there would have been an R block or a sky block. Sky block, an air block. Mm-hmm. So there's always something true. So that's why it will always execute this program or the line of code I'm going to place here over and over again. So what I'm going to do is turtle dot detect and then 2 brackets. What this will do is this will detect if there's something in front of the turtle. So what we're going to do then is if turtle dot detect equals double equals, so it's the same as something. You can also do is smaller than the same as something, but turtle detect that can only be true or false. It isn't a number that can be higher or lower, so you're basically going to want 2 equal signs. If it is true, so if there is something on the front of the turtle, then, oh, I forgot it. If you've got an advanced computer or advanced turtle, you can click somewhere and your cursor will automatically, or your little thingy will automatically go there, and you don't need to go all the way over there with your arrow keys. But anyway, then, don't forget that, pretty important. Then I wanted to do turtle dot attack. Wait a second, how do you spell that? This with double T was a little bit insecure up there. So turtle attack, I think you need 2 brackets, I don't know, but we'll find out. Do turtle attack, and then I want to end this line of code. So if that happens, then do that, and then you're going to end it here. And what that means is you can go on with your code from while do. So you could do like, if this is true, do that. But if it's not true, or if it's true, doesn't matter if it's true or not, you are always going to do this after you have done turtle attack or not, if you know what I mean. So I could do like turtle dot forward, and then free. But I'm not going to do that, because if a turtle needs to move, it needs fuel, and I don't have fuel in here. Well, I can use blaze rods, of course, but by the way, if a turtle kills an enemy, the drops will automatically land in this little inventory over here. So that's something we're going to use. But because we don't want it to do something else, we're just going to end it here. Just then press Ctrl to access menu. So we're going to Ctrl, and then we're going to save. So just press Enter. Saved to blaze kill. Then Ctrl, exit. And to execute a program, do blaze kill. And then we should see something. And if I would go and stand in front of here, it should attack me. It does not do that. There's something wrong. Maybe it used to kill you as well, but it might not. Edit blaze kill. So turtle detect, if turtle detect equals to then turtle attack or detect. It should do it. Well, let's do exit blaze kill. And let's check if we place a blob up here, it's going to punch. No, it's not going to punch. So it doesn't really detect. Hello. So, okay, it might not work on me, but only on blazes, and otherwise I can change this and say that it would... Oh, by the way, Ctrl T and you will terminate the program. So that will automatically stop, basically. So what I want is, I want to pull those items out. Let's do that. And then I want to get them into these chests. And I don't think... Oh, of course, I can't change this because I don't have a wrench on me. Can I make a wrench? Oh, by the way, you need a crescent hammer, so... Hammer. Hopefully I can make it. So it's one tin. Oh yes, yeah, so of course I can make that for sure. So let's first go and place these things. It's not going to do that. Let's get that redstone signal going, I guess. Redstone signal doesn't affect a turtle unless you have written that in its program. So if you have written check for redstone signal, it will check for redstone signal. But otherwise it will not. Did I make this one too high? I made this one too high. Of course I did. So what you can do is you can label. Do label. That's an already that's already in there. So label. Label, set, and then blazes. Enter. So what it will do is, if I destroy that one now, melee turtle is blazes melee turtle. Or that's what it says right now. Yes, I'm placing that one too far back. That. And this, and I place it wrong. Of course I did. So what you do with labeling is, you basically, if I would do blaze kill right now, it will still do that program. It will remember each program it had in it. So that's pretty nifty. So we have all this here. So I will make a crescent hammer, and I will be right back. And hello, crescent hammer. And welcome back, guys. So I've made it, as you could see a second ago. So what you can do with the crescent hammer is you see that blue thingy right there. If I right click with my crescent hammer on there, it will turn red. And what that does is, instead of, you need to see it like an arrow. Oh yes, if you right click another time, it will disconnect, so it won't interact with that inventory. But you need to see it as an arrow. So now it looks like an arrow that goes up and into the turtle. So that's basically what it does. Here, arrow into the chest, arrow into the chest. Well, that's what we want. We want items to go into this chest. But we don't want items to go into the turtle. We want to get the blaze rods out of the turtle. So right click with your crescent hammer and you see an arrow pointing out the turtle. So I've placed a lever up there, and that should activate this thing. So let's turn on the spawner. It's going to happen, guys. Right click. Yes, already spawned one. So I got to keep this thing. Is that a bug? I'm definitely not in creative. Hello guys, sorry for that. I was having a little crash up here. Always nice. But as you can see, we have a problem. Turtle doesn't work, so now I need to get inside this hole. It's going to work. No blazes. So let's try it this way. Hopefully I can access the turtle. Yes. Oh, that's because it shut itself down, of course. Nope. It doesn't do that. So edit blaze skill. So what you need to do is you basically need to go here, press, nope, go away, delete up here, really sucks my delete key. I have like a delete key with that also is a point, so that's annoying. So I always need to press shift delete to get the actual delete. So anyway, save, exit, blaze skill. Oh, something wrong. Edit blaze skill. And yes, what I did is I deleted that statement with if turtle detects is true, then so I don't need that second end up there. So blaze skill. Yes, so it's working, as you can see. They are slowly but surely dying. Oh, there are loads of blazes in here. That spawner was spawning like crazy. Ho ho! Holy. I am getting blaze rods. I think the turtle can keep up with the amount that is dropped by the blazes. So kill them blazes. Why did this thing not pick up any blaze rods? It should. But it doesn't. Anyway, 16 blaze rods in an instant, got a lot of XP. That's very nice. But I need to stop this stuff. So let's get up. Oh, snap. We forgot to cover this up. That was alright. Should be alright. Okay, now they're all tracking me. That wasn't a very good decision. So let's try to disable that spawner for a second. Let's get up. So no, that's not going to happen. I need to turn off that spawner. How am I going to do that? Let's try to fast. Okay, I'm going to die. I am so going to die right now. The only way out is by doing that. Slain by computer craft. So yes. Okay, I will see you in a second. And welcome back. So I got my stuff. That's great news, but yeah, no way to do anything to turn it off, but they are not tracking me, I think, but they're also not falling in those holes, so I might want to change some stuff up. Then I need my lever. Turn it off. Get out of here. Nice. So now it should be good. Can I let these guys despawn? I don't think so. But I need pistons then. Clearly. And this thing shut itself down, so play skill. Do that, my friend. So it's pretty good, it's working. I got 18 blaze rods, 8 shards of minium. I can basically AFK here and it should be okay. But I do want this to pick that stuff up, and it used to do that automatically, but it doesn't. Not anymore, at least. So how do I want to do that? Oh, they're all tracking me now because I opened that hole. I think they're tracking me through wall. So yeah, let's get myself some bread. Oh wait, I'm not hungry. So anyway, I consider this project as done. I might want to add some pistons, but I'm considering. I don't know if I should because I don't have that much resources. Although, if I would place 4 pistons right there just to push the last ones into the middle, it should already be a great help. So 4 pistons for sticky pistons, I should be able to handle that. So let me finish this episode. Yes, so I think this is a pretty long episode already, so let me call it here, guys. In the next episode I'll probably add those 4 little pistons up there. And I will probably start with my sorting system and my chest, so that would be great. And well, no, I think that's next episode we're going to work on some machines, because we need some ore maceration or pulverization. So we can get some resources out of that, and we can use those resources for making a nice little sorting system. So that's what we're going to do next episode. I hope you've enjoyed this one. Like, subscribe, favorite if you obviously liked it. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and then I will see you next episode. Goodbye.